Overcast is one of the most popular podcast apps on iPhone, and it just celebrated its 10-year anniversary with a huge redesign, lots of new features, and I'm going to put it head-to-head against Pocket Cast, my current favorite podcast app of choice. I recently compared it to Apple Podcasts, and you can check out that video in the description, but I'm going to go over the new design and features you can find in Overcast, how it compares to Pocket Cast, and some things I'm hoping to see in some future updates. I'm going to focus on the Overcast app here on the iPhone, but you can also get it for iPad and Mac, but the Apple Watch app is unchanged. That big update is coming. And to start off, I want to go straight to the Now Playing screen for a current episode. Now when you're playing a podcast, Overcast has a full screen view of this Now Playing screen. You might remember previously, it kind of had this card view where you would swipe left and right and you would see the show notes over here, and then the chapters would live in another card, and the audio settings lived in there too. With the new Overcast redesign, and you can theme the colors whether it's dark or light mode, I have it right here in dark mode, just so you know this is what it looks like in light mode, you now have full screen views of things like the show notes and chapters. Tap the eye icon and you'll get the full show notes for this episode. Overcast formats show notes really nicely, very similar to Pocket Casts, and way better than Apple Podcasts. You can also view the chapter list by tapping here and jump to a specific chapter, skip to the next chapter using this button, and the audio controls like Smart Speed and Voice Boost, those all live down here. Overall, I think this is an improvement, especially for things like show notes. Having that in a larger view as opposed to in that tiny card looks way better. And there's some hidden features that are really cool, like if you scrub far forward in an episode, you'll see this little pop-up where you can actually jump back to where you were just listening, and you'll see that X is actually a little timer, letting you know how much time you have to actually tap to go back. You can also swipe down or tap this little pill icon to go into a mini player, and I like that the custom chapter artwork or episode artwork is shown down here in the mini player. Also a nice little animation here on the pause button when an episode is currently playing. For reference, Pocket Cast doesn't have the little animated player, but you do get that custom episode or chapter artwork in their mini player as well, and you get quick access to the queue, which more on that in a second. Also, on that mini player in Overcast, there are no skip forward and back buttons, whereas when you're playing in Pocket Cast, you can quickly skip forward and back, which is nice. So while I do think this Now Playing screen is an improvement over the previous Overcast, there's a couple things I'm missing when I'm coming from Pocket Cast. First of all, there's no swipe gestures for getting to things like the show notes or your up next queue. Everything is an actual tap, whether it's on the eye icon or the chapter list. One of the things that did bring me back to Pocket Cast is the swipe gestures. I can swipe up and quickly get to my up next queue. I can swipe to the right and get the show notes, swipe again for chapters. This swiping gesture in Pocket Cast helps me get around really fast, and I think I prefer that rather than tapping on different targets. Also, you can skip forward a chapter here, but in Pocket Cast, you can actually go forward or back a chapter using these buttons. Also, here in Overcast, there's not really a way to get to your up next queue, so I can't see what episode is going to be coming next when I'm on this Now Playing screen. I would have to go back out and I might see episodes here, or I can go to my queue in this playlist icon, but I would love to be able to see what episode is coming next quickly right here from the Now Playing screen. Again, here in Pocket Cast, that's just a swipe up and I see all the episodes that are coming next and I can quickly reorder them by dragging the handles there. Also, I do think Pocket Cast takes better advantage of the screen real estate down here. There's a share button right here on the Now Playing screen where I can share the current position, episode, or link to the full podcast. And this feature, which I just discovered coming back to Pocket Cast and I've been using a lot, which is actually bookmarking a specific timestamp in an episode. I love having that icon right here on the Now Playing screen. Currently, Overcast does not allow you to bookmark specific timestamps, but I can tap the eye icon, then hit the share button, then I can get a link to the episode, the current time code, and a big advantage Overcast has is actually sharing a clip from this episode, which will create a video file that you can share on social media. Also, you can export the audio file here, which is unique to Overcast. And the three dots gives me even more options like the sleep timer, starring the episode, and more. While I understand keeping the Now Playing screen clean is a nice look in Overcast, I do think there could be better use of the screen real estate, especially down here. Now, I know the Overcast creator, Marco Arman, also likes the iPhone mini, and this might look a little better on that size screen. But since there is no more iPhone mini, so we're dealing mainly with regular and Pro Max size phones, I think putting a little more controls right here on the Now Playing screen would be beneficial. But like I mentioned, one unique feature to Overcast, Castro has this as well, but I wish they would bring it to Pocket Cast or even Apple Podcasts, is the Share a Clip feature. And this whole editor is actually really powerful, enabling you to create a quick video file, pulling a timestamp from the current episode you're listening to, having a nice little card here, and then being able to share that on social media. This feature is still great. I see a lot of people sharing clips of podcasts on social media using it, so kudos for that feature still being here and working great. Now, one of the big things that did not change in this redesign, but also sets Overcast apart, is the audio engine. Marco Arment is a, I think, self-proclaimed audiophile, and he's put a lot of work into things like Smart Speed, which removes silences during playback, but also does a lot of other things to just make the audio sound good, like in the Voice Boost feature. Pocket Cast also has a Voice Boost feature. If I go to the audio settings here, you can see I could change the speed, trim silence, and volume boost, but I do find that Overcast performs better when doing things like that boost and Smart Speed. So if you use those features a lot, Overcast is probably worth a try because it does make your podcast just sound better. You can also customize these settings per podcast and make them permanent just for this show. And you can go up to 3x speeds, although I don't know why you would do that, where Pocket Cast only goes to 2x and then back to 1. Don't listen to podcasts at 3x. Just don't. I'll also say when it comes to syncing playback position and your different playlists, syncing for Overcast is rock solid. But I will say Pocket Cast is also very solid in that syncing both your current playback destination and your up next queue, which for me is really important. That up next queue is basically the one playlist I work with in my podcast app. Now, if you do want to hear more about the syncing and the backend work Marco Arment did in this 10th anniversary redesign, I encourage you to listen to the episode of ATP that talks about this complete overhaul and how he used Swift UI for like 99% of the app. Really interesting, especially if you want to hear about his database syncing and all that. I'll link the episode down in the description. Now, aside from the now playing screen, let's actually look at what a specific show page will look like. Here's Primary Technology, my tech podcast with Jason Aten. You should definitely subscribe. Links are down in the description. Pretty clean show page. Of course, you have the three dots where you have other options like different podcast settings, marking played or unplayed, and more. And you can hit the eye icon to go to a specific episode, and you'll see the same show notes you would from the now playing screen. If I tap on an episode, you also get this little quick bar where you have the three dots. You can star the episode, share icon, allowing you to quickly create clips, and more. And Overcast also has a search icon here in the top right, where you can search just episodes of Primary Technology. So if you're looking for episodes that just talk about Gemini, you can see the most relevant and the most recent episodes. That's really cool. Pocket Cast also has a per podcast search. You see that search bar right here, and it'll pull up any episodes that mention that name. But I give Overcast an edge here for both giving you the newest episodes and most relevant. That's pretty cool. One thing I do miss here in Overcast is the progress on the play button. You'll see here in Pocket Cast in the episode listing, the little play button actually has a circle showing the amount of progress that you've listened to that episode. Just a nice little design touch here in Pocket Cast. And one other thing that both Pocket Cast and Overcast is missing is I would love to see the custom episode artwork either in the episode listing or on the episode page. Even here in Pocket Cast, when I tap an episode, it doesn't show the custom episode artwork. That's one of the advantages I would actually give to Apple Podcasts. When you're looking at an individual show in Apple Podcasts, I love that you see the custom episode artwork in the episode listing. I think that looks great. And when I tap an individual episode, that custom episode artwork shows large on that episode page. I do miss that both in Pocket Casts and in Overcast. So just a feature request for both of them. Overall, I don't spend a lot of time here on specific show pages, but what you do see all the time is the home screen. And you will see some new design elements here on the Overcast home screen. You have current and playing episodes here at the top, which is customizable. I'll get to that in a second. Your playlist under that, and then your list of podcasts underneath. You can, of course, pin certain podcasts to the top of that list. And in case you forgot, this is previously what Overcast looked like. No episode listing or currently playing up at the top. Playlists were kind of these large pills above these recent shows, and then you had all shows underneath that. I do think this looks better, and I like seeing these recent and new episodes up at the top. If you wanted to tap an episode, it'll immediately just start playing that episode that you tapped here on the home screen. I think I like that, although it's a little unclear how to manage what episodes are appearing in this top list. I would love to be able to tap and hold on one of these episodes and have a little contextual menu like remove from queue or add to up next, but there is no long press. As soon as you tap on one, that episode just starts playing. Now, if you don't like that in general, you can jump into the Overcast settings, and here under the customize home screen, you can hide the show recent episodes, and you can also hide the playlists if you want. And now you won't see those at the top. Now you just have playlists and your podcast shows. When it comes to playlists, you can have your all episodes playlist, you have your queue, then also priority podcasts where you can add certain shows to be priority, and you can see your downloaded shows there as well. One thing that might not be immediately obvious is if you go to the queue, you can actually reorder what episodes you're going to be listening to, even though there's not the little three hamburger lines over here. That is one thing I like about Pocket Casts. It's just really obvious that you can reorder them, and that three-line hamburger menu, I think it's just kind of like a universal UI. Hey, you can click and drag this up and down. You can drag them up and down here in Overcast, but instead of the three-line hamburger menu, you have this eye icon if you want to see the episode show notes. When it comes to queue, I think having those three lines is a little more obvious to say, hey, you can reorder these episodes. You can also tap the three dots here and change the playlist settings. Lots of playlist settings like before. You can customize the color, the icon, sorting episodes, what podcasts you want to include in this playlist, choose only specific ones, and even set high and low priority podcasts for this particular playlist. You can also go with ranked and groupings of different episodes of the shows, and you can also do the additional or excluded episodes for this particular playlist. The way I use a podcast player, I don't typically create multiple playlists. I usually just go by my up next list, and that's kind of the written in stone, here are the episodes I still have to listen to, and what's coming next. But if you like having playlists, different priorities, customizing what shows are in which playlist, I think Overcast does a great job in making that visually appealing and easy to manage. But I will say Pocket Cast also has a filters tab, and these basically act as those same kinds of playlists. You can choose what shows will appear in a specific filter, played and unplayed episodes. So you can create those kind of playlists right here in Pocket Cast as well. A nice little feature here is any currently playing podcast, like I'm playing the latest episode of Cortex, that podcast will actually have a little speaker icon on the artwork. Nice little touch. And there's also a search icon right here on the home screen of Overcast. You can search any and all podcasts if you're looking for a new show in a specific category, or you can go to My Episodes and just search within the podcast you follow. And when I do that, you'll see my movies podcast, Movies on the Side, did an episode on Gemini Man, some Vergecast with that, and Primary Technology, of course. So I do like that home screen search, and you can also add a podcast directly by URL right here. Finally, let's jump into the settings real quick of Overcast. I do like this little redesign of the settings page and having these nice icons. You can customize the notifications per show, the download and delete download behavior per podcast and overall. And you can change the seek back and forward and do that up to 90 seconds. A personal preference of mine is actually changing the seek forward by more than 90 seconds. Here in Pocket Cast, I actually have the skip forward at 3 minutes because a lot of shows I listen to have a lot of ads. And so I actually find having that a longer time, like 3 minutes, and then the skip backwards as 30 seconds gives me a little more control over that listening. So I would love to see more options here above 90 seconds. You can change the theme and colors depending on light and dark mode. And there's still the nitpicky detail settings. Smart resume is really nice, actually going back a few seconds when you start playing an episode after being paused for a while. Seek acceleration is also a nice feature, and some other settings down here. Now, one consternation I've seen from Overcast users is the removal of streaming playback. Now, if you want to play an episode of a podcast and it's not downloaded, you'll actually see it has to download first. There is no streaming option. You'll see the little download progress bar here, and then we'll start playing immediately after downloading. I understand why some people like streaming, just being able to play a podcast, quote unquote, immediately. But Marco Arment's reasoning for this is the dynamic ad insertion a lot of shows do will kind of mess with that streaming, and it's just not a good experience. I actually agree. I don't like streaming podcasts at all. I will always download an episode before I listen to it, even in Pocket Cast, which allows streaming. So I don't see this as an issue. If streaming is important to you, I'd be curious why. Maybe you could tell me down in the comments, but no more streaming. You have to download any and all episodes you play in Overcast. And two other features I still use and enjoy here in Pocket Cast is the ability to upload audio files directly to the app. I do this sometimes if I want to review an episode I've edited, but I'm not ready to publish it. I can just upload it right here. It syncs to my Pocket Cast cloud and I can play it like a regular podcast. And I also like the listening history that Pocket Cast gives you, showing you episodes you've recently played. And you get fun little stats like 141 days listened of podcasts. And that's even with me using Apple Podcasts for the last year or so. Overall, I think Overcast has some really good improvements, especially in how it uses more screen real estate to display show notes and chapter listings like so. The back end is obviously very improved, and overall the app is very fast because much of it, pretty much all of it, is Swift UI. So really responsive, really fast and lightweight. And I like those little Easter egg features like scrubbing forward and being able to skip back right here on the now playing screen. That's pretty cool. For me personally, I'm going to stick to Pocket Cast as my main podcast app. If you want to check out all my reasonings for that and why I tried Apple Podcasts for a year and just couldn't hang with it, I'll put that video right up here where I compare Pocket Cast to Apple Podcasts. And if you have any questions about Overcast or other podcast apps, leave comments below this video. Love to answer you there. And if you want to learn more about iOS 18, which is in public beta right now, and of course the full release is coming this fall, check out my iOS 18 features video right up here. And I also have a video on the top features in macOS Sequoia. I'll put that video down in the description as well. Kudos to Marco Arment for making Overcast and its 10-year anniversary. That's amazing. And it's a one-man show. There's not a team of people developing Overcast. It's just Marco. So awesome work. Really appreciate the redesign and some of the cool new features. And I'll be watching for that updated Apple Watch app because I do enjoy my Pocket Cast Apple Watch app and I'd love to see what you do with that too. Thanks for watching. I'll catch you next time.